Everyone, in this tutorial I am going to animate a cam, and for this I have designed the base. First, I have made a sketch. Distance from the origin, and it has these dimensions. As you see, that dimension is 50 and that dimension is 100, and that angle is 105, as like as this angle, and it is 50 and 50 almost, also 100 by 100 and 105 degrees and 300 millimeter distance to the origin. And I have extruded with the YZ plane, and I have sketched a square at the XY plane, and the position is as like as this one is 150 by 150 and 150 by 150, and it is centered, but the circle, it is not completely from origin. It has 10 millimeter distance from the Y direction. And I have also extruded with 70, I suppose. 75 millimeter. Okay, and I have designed a cam. As it is a circle with diameter 100 millimeter, 100 millimeter from the origin, and another circle with the 200 millimeter diameter with the 100 millimeter from the origin. And also I have designed a circle with 30 millimeter diameter at the center of that circle. And then I have drawn a line which is tangent to two arcs, and that one to that one too. And I have trimmed the extra arcs and lines. Okay, and I have used a multipad, and the first one is that one with 20 millimeter thick, and the second one is that circle with 70 millimeter thick. I have made a follower, have extruded circle with 30 diameter, 30 millimeter in diameter, and extruded with 200 millimeter, and I have made a square. On XY plane, or yes, XY plane, and it is centered with 40 by 40, and it is centered in the origin, and I have extruded with 10 millimeter thick, and then I have sketched on this plane of the square of the square, and I have made a rectangle 60 by 40, and it is a circle with 15 millimeter diameter and 20 millimeter from the lower edge, and I have also extruded 10, and I have mirrored through the YZ plane, and then I have made a fillet with 20 millimeter 20 millimeter radius. Then I have designed a roller. I have made a circle with diameter 20, and I have extruded with 20 millimeter, I suppose. I have extruded 10 millimeter on this side and 10 millimeter on another side, because I wanted use a use a mirror, and I have designed that circle with 15 millimeter in diameter at the center of that cylinder, and I have extruded with the 20, and then I have mirrored it through the YZ plane. Okay, now I am going to start a mechanical design, assembly design, and I am going to right click on product and component, existing component, and I take the base first. Okay, now I am going to add the component with the cam, and as you see it is up there, and I can use manipulated, and the X direction is that direction, and I am going to use that one, select and move. Now I am going to make a coincident constraint, and I am going to select that one and zoom in to that one, and I am going to use update, and I am going to make an offset between that one and that one, and make it 0. Zero and update. Now it is sitting there. Surface, and it is this face to this face. They are connected and it is not internal, external, otherwise it's going to be inside. And I am going to select UCO and update. Now they are connected to each other. I have all those constraints, and I am going to fix the base, and then I am going to make a Revolut rotate. I am going to make a Revolut between base height. To reach that one, I make a base show, and the planner make the base, select this face of the base height again, and select that one and show the base, and activate, check the offset, it's automatically minus 20, and accept it. And you must make it angle driven in the tree. Open application, mechanism one, joints, and right click on revolute and edit definition and make it angle driven and use it from 0 to 360 or maybe 720. Okay. Now I am going to have a roll curve joint, and it is the first curve. I am going to move and zoom in to reach that curve, and the second curve is this one, and use a length driven UCO, and then I am going to have a revolute between this one and make the roller height to reach this one, and the plane, make the roller show, and the plane is this one, and the plane of the follower is this one, and it is angle driven as no angle driven. I don't think so. It has a roller. Now I am going to have a planar planar joint and plane one is this one, and plane two I am going to zoom in, and the plane two joint between that line, and I am going to make the follower height to reach that line. Thank you. increase the ratio, and I am going to run. As you see, it's going to warp and then it's rotating backwards. Now it is rotating forwards two times and rotating backwards two times. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.